you're joining Dukoskopi TV at the IFX Expo here in Cyprus 2014. With the help of our partners, we're quizzing the industry elite on what makes Cyprus such a good option and also asking their top strategy tip. With me in the TV booth right now is Orr Kapelinski from I4X. Orr, welcome to the booth.
Hi, thank you very much for inviting us.
A pleasure to see you here. Now, let's talk firstly about Cyprus. Yes. We find ourselves here at the IFX Expo, but where does the attraction lie of having an FX operation in Cyprus? What are the advantages and indeed the disadvantages, would you say?
You can see around us in this convention that Cyprus in the last years really became a major hub for our industry. I'm relocated here for 3 years, so I see three major factors that make Cyprus such a good hub for our industry. I think the first one is the regulator, which is very strict, but also very professional and understand the business needs and communicate with us. It makes us a very special place to work in. The second factor, I think it's connected also to the first factor, is the high quality of professionals surrounding us here in Cyprus, which are very essential to our business. For instance, lawyers, accounting firms, and consultants that give us a very good hub to manage our business. And I think that in the last days you feel the weather and the hospitality of the society, and the fact that every Cypriot is speaking English. For international company or groups like I4X, is a very good place location-wise and culture-wise to operate a headquarters, because Cyprus is first of all a junction between East and West. It's the weather and the hospitality gives us a very good environment for employees to relocate Forex specialists from around the world to create a nice atmosphere. And I think this is what makes Cyprus such a good hub for our industry.
Fantastic. So if we sort of flip reverse it, and if we have a look at the equation from the customer's side of things, for clients, what do you consider to be an absolute must for them to consider when they're opening a Forex account with a broker?
So I look at it at three criteria, like every decision we make in life. First of all is the experience. Second, I think I will say it in a vast word, is the establishment of the organization. Obviously, when someone can develop and own his own platforms and own IT, he's more established. This is a factor that I think any client should consider. The third factor, obviously, is the services. I see a lot of brokers in the world investing so many resources in the marketing and the onboarding process. However, 1 minute after the client finishes onboarding, they forget him. Are they going to train you? Are they going to provide you educational material? Are they going to call you when you are in a need? Do they have operating customer support, not only chats, somebody that you can speak with? This is things that are essential. If I was a new client in the industry, these are the factors that I will consider.
Fantastic. Now, if we do just talk a little bit about social media, this is something which has really revolutionized the industry and the world, how people go about their daily lives, from interacting, finding news information, and also transacting. But as for I4X, how do you approach this? When the world's moving ever faster and communication, of course, is key, how do you strategize against these trends?
First of all, I will not say it's against these trends. It's with those trends. And I agree. You cannot ignore what the social platforms are doing now in the world. But I see that you need to take these strategies with a bit caution, because in the end, we should not forget that we are dealing with financial details and private information of our clients. So to say that we are an I4X, for instance, when we saw the platforms, the social platforms are going in and everybody's jumping to the water, we decided to take a safer approach. We learned the risk around those platforms. And in the last year, we are developing the strategy that both, one, will ride this trend, and of course, we cannot forget it, but on the contrary, safeguard our clients, their financial information. And I know that in the end of 2014, we will fully launch our strategy. But to your question, I agree, and we are there.
Excellent, fantastic. Now, if we talk a little bit about globalization, it's important, imperative even, to have a local presence in a global market. But how? What is your approach? Do you try to have a foothold in many different regions, or do you perhaps try to find that niche with the largest market potential?
The answer is more complicated than a physical present or non-physical present. We are supporting 23 languages, so obviously we are supporting 23 cultures, and we do understand that every culture holds its own factors, its own, the important things are a little bit different. But what's again is important in the service we provide.
And just lastly, if you wouldn't mind, or could you tell us what would be your top tip for someone looking to perhaps be a startup as an FX broker? What advice would you give them in terms of strategy?
I think that the best solution or the best advice I can give a newcomer to the industry is think well before you are entering, because it's not just to license MT4 platform and to have a marketing agency. In the end, we are dealing with in the financial markets. We are participants in the financial market. So if you don't really understand the financial markets, the risk behind it, and all the surrounding of this business, I will first learn them very good and then think if I want to enter this industry, which is beautiful, by the way, but you need to be very professional in order to make it
happen. Of course.
Happen.
Fantastic. Or thank you so much for coming.
Pleasure.
Great to have your insights today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, well, that's all from Orr and myself for the moment, but make sure you keep clicking back to find out all the insider info from the IFX Expo here in Cyprus 2014. Goodbye for now.